What's good, MABW team? What's going on today, MABW fam? I'm back today with another video. In today's video, I just wanted to drop some real quick truth bombs and state something that I think that a lot of men have been stating to women for a long time. And I believe some other women have been stating this too on their channels, which is not far from the truth. Currently, a lot of people, especially black women, they expected Joe Biden to handle student loan debt. Now, I stated this before. I stated that a lot of you women out there, because y'all the ones that helped get him in there, y'all were the ones that were by popular vote, women voted for Joe Biden the most, especially black women. And one of the things that y'all were voting for him on was student loan debt relief. A lot of y'all thought that Joe Biden was gonna come in here and wipe away student loan debt from y'all. And that's by far from the case. And to tell you the truth, it's not gonna happen. And if it does happen, it's probably only gonna be by like 10%, 10 or 20%. Now, the Supreme Court's student loan decision will impact black women the most. From the article that I'm currently reading on Syracuse.com, okay, by NerdWallet, there's a story talking about how the Supreme Court student loan decision will impact black women the most. I'm going to read a little bit from this article, and I want y'all to tell me what y'all think, because one thing that I know, especially after being in the military during my time and then getting out, I know that the government isn't here to help you. I know that the government is trying to keep you down in the shallows. I know that government also panders to people they pander to minorities, especially black people. They sit up here and tell y'all everything that they want to give to y'all to keep y'all down, and y'all don't even understand it. They always keep on telling y'all, for one, that they're gonna keep on upping y'all food stamps at the end of the month. They keep on telling y'all that as long as y'all don't have a black man in y'all household, they'll give y'all a certain percent of income to stay in the project housing that y'all are staying in. Y'all don't wanna hear me though, and y'all don't wanna hear nobody else when we state this type of stuff to y'all. Now, the fate of up to $20,000 in student loan cancellation for over 40 million borrowers is now in the hands of the Supreme Court. One group, however, has the most to lose if the court decides against the Biden administration. That group is black women. Now, this isn't coming out of my mouth to slander black women. This is coming from an article, okay? So remember that. I'm just reading it. I'm reporting the news, okay? We are told that if you get your education, you can make more money, says Tissa Silver Kennedy, author of Borrowing While Black. And then you find yourself in a situation where the education that was supposed to open doors has put you in the biggest trap of your life. To Tissa Silver Kennedy, us men, we already know that. For the most part, us men already know that. That's nothing new. That's nothing new. A lot of y'all go to college and y'all think that that little certificate that they give y'all at the end of 4 years, 8 years, 10 years, 12 years, y'all think that y'all are gonna come out and be on top. All that certificate is doing, that little degree that you got, to be honest with you, all it's doing is holding you back. Because when you come out of college, you have to go into the working field. Once you get into the working field, you're not making as much money as expected that you think you were going to make when you come out of college. And even if you are coming out of college making a decent amount of money, you still have to pay the government back a substantial amount of money on those student loans. If you're making $100,000 a year and you got to pay the government back damn near $40,000 a year, that's not a win. That's not a win. A lot of y'all paying back up to $250,000 in debt, in student loan debt, $200,000, going to grad school, $500,000 to come out, and most of y'all don't even make that type of money. A lot of y'all are coming out of colleges with bachelor's degree and only making $20 an hour. And you got people that's going to trade school at 18, coming out making at least 50 grand or better and not owing the government nothing. They don't owe the government nothing. And this is why I state that I don't believe in college. I believe all school and college is indoctrination too. Sending more puppets into the school system to get indoctrinated, to vote for democratic governments that are trying to keep you down while they steal your money. You don't even know it. Whose fault is it that they want to go to college? Is it the white man's fault, or is it the people that want to go to these colleges and give them all their money? Whose fault is it? I don't blame the white man for that. I blame the people that are going to college still believing that they're going to come out and make it big time. For some, it does help them out substantially. But for the most part, it doesn't help the average black woman who comes out of college. A lot of black women that I know that have came out of colleges, big colleges, they aren't making more than $20 an hour. And they're struggling. And they're taking on second jobs to pay back the government. Uncle Sam is stealing your money. Y'all too bamboozled to know that. Now, let's get back to the article. Black women bear a disproportionate amount of the $1.6 trillion federal student debt total, with higher debt averages than any other demographic. For example, black women have 43% more undergraduate debt and nearly 99% more graduate school debt than their white woman counterparts 12 months after graduation. All that means is y'all coming out and y'all not getting jobs in the field that y'all went to college for. Straight up. Y'all gonna have to come up with a different plan. I'm just here to report the news and educate. That's all I wanna do. I wouldn't recommend anybody go to college this day and age to give the government their money. Because as soon as you go into college, it's like walking into a car dealership and buying a brand new car, thinking you're going to get a good resale value on it a year later. Soon as you walk off the lot with that car, it depreciates. I'm looking at college now, like soon as you go to college, you pretty much are depreciating yourself. That piece of paper doesn't mean anything no more. Take that piece of paper and just go like this with it and throw it in the garbage after you come out of college. It doesn't mean anything anymore. It doesn't mean anything at all. You're going into college and you're losing money. And if y'all want, y'all can read the rest of this article. It's on Syracuse.com. It's on Syracuse.com. Right here, front lines. Y'all thinking that y'all going to college is going to improve y'all life, when in all actuality, it's not. And then y'all want to come out and blame somebody. Nobody forced y'all to go to college. Nobody put a gun to y'all head and told y'all to take out all this student loan, take out all these student loans, come out and end up in debt. Nobody forced you. That's why you need to do your research on colleges more. Do your research on if college is really going to help you when you come out of school. Because these degrees ain't doing nothing for y'all no more. I would always tell my people to go get a trade. Seriously, because I feel that a trade is more valuable these days, and you're not coming out with a substantial amount of debt that you'll be paying until you retire. You might be paying that debt until your death date, literally. And then y'all think that, you know, some of y'all want to work up until y'all get Social Security. Let me tell y'all something right now, too. Social Security is a myth in my eyes. I would never want to work for somebody until I'm 62, 65, or 72 just to get back a couple of dollars in my golden years. which I honestly believe your golden year should start in your mid-40s or as soon as you're 50. Your golden year shouldn't be starting at 65. I got to work all my life for the government just to give me back $1,500 to $2,000 a month that I got to try to stretch out. I'm going for mine. I'm not waiting. I don't believe in 401ks and all that pinch. I don't believe in all that no more. I've been stopped believing in that. I'm working for somebody forever until I'm 70 to enjoy my golden years. I want to enjoy my golden years when I'm 45. I'm going to be truthful. When I turn 45, that's when I want to enjoy my golden years. That's golden years for me. What can you really do when you're 65 or 70? How can you really enjoy your life? How? You're 65, getting a couple of dollars every month to survive on, 12 months out the year. And then they want to tell you if you work and make over this amount of money, some of your benefits could be possibly stopped or you won't end up getting that much. How is that fair to you? If I can make more than what the IRS is, or if I can make more than what Uncle Sam is giving me, you're going to try to take some of my money away from me. If I decide to withdraw some of my money and retire earlier, you're going to make me face a penalty? Fuck out of here. Anyways, that's my video for today. If you like the video, of course, comment, like, and subscribe. It ain't costing you a damn thing. And of course, I'm going to holla back at y'all later. Peace.